Today, we are going to show you how to programmatically implement a simple HTTP call in a BTP ABAP system. My name is Frank and this is my colleague Mark. I will guide you through the step-by-step process, what an ABAP developer needs to do in the ADT, and Mark will then demonstrate how to configure the necessary settings in various SAP Fiori Launchpad applications. As a developer, the first step is to create a communication target. With the communication target, a corresponding communication target class is generated. This class is also inactive, but it will be activated synchronously when the communication target is activated. We'll use this class later in the code. At this point, there are several configuration options available. Since we are working with a BTP system for this example, we can only create client-specific communication target. It is possible to store multiple configurations for a communication target, which are called application destinations. A communication target can be bound to either a single application destination or to many. For our case, we will keep things simple and allow only one configuration. Dynamic destinations are also not allowed in the BTP ABAP environment, so the grayed out field is irrelevant. You can then configure a path prefix, which determines the resource to which the HTTP request is sent. In our case, we choose subpublic ping. Once the configuration is completed, we can activate our object. Now, let me show you the code needed to send the HTTP request. The first step is to create a reference of the type of the communication target class we just created. The second step is to create our communication target object. With this communication target object, we can now create a client object. On this client object, we can apply the execute method, which sends the request and receives the response. Using the getStatus method, we can also read the HTTP response code. When we run the code, we will see that no successful HTTP call has been made yet. For this, the developer still needs to create two more objects. First, an outbound service, and second, a communication scenario. After creation, click on Publish locally. These are all the steps a developer needs to carry out. Now, my colleague Mark will show you the configuration steps that still need to be done.
When you are logged on to your system, search for the Display Communication Scenarios app. Open the app and search for the created communication scenario. Display the details of your communication scenario and create a communication arrangement for this. On the next screen, create a new communication system. Choose a suitable system ID and system name. Now maintain all the necessary data that is used to connect to your system. Now save your communication system. After saving, you will be navigated back to the Communication Arrangement app. Finally, save it. Now you can use it to establish an HTTP outbound call in your code. Let's go back to the implementation of the application in ADT. You can use the Communication Arrangement to establish and trigger an HTTP outbound call from your ABAP BTP system. You can now use the created Communication Arrangement to trigger outbound HTTP calls in any of your applications.